this short video, we're going to look at camber angles in reference to steering and suspension geometry. Other angles include caster, kingpin inclination, steering axis inclination, and scrub radius, which we'll look at in other videos. Looking from the front of the car, camber is the inward or outward tilting of the wheels at the top. Positive camber is the tilting out at the top, and negative camber is the tilting in at the top. Camber is measured in degrees and set by the vehicle or suspension system manufacturer, which can be found in the maintenance manual or technical specifications. For demonstration purposes, the camber angles in the following animations have been exaggerated. When making a turn or cornering, due to the weight transference that comes from body roll and the lateral force applied to the tyres due to the centrifugal effect on the vehicle, the tyre walls deform, reducing the contact patch of the tyre on the road. Introducing a small amount of negative camber counteracts this effect on cornering, increasing the tyre's contact with the road and improving directional stability and handling. Although negative camber improves handling in corners, it will go some way to reduce the car's straight line performance on acceleration and braking, due to the reduced tyre contact patch when travelling in a straight line, which will also prematurely wear the tyres. Modern car designers will take this into account to make a compromise between cornering and straight line performance. Negative camber can be readily seen on track going race cars like Formula One, where the tyre remains in optimal contact with the track surface during high speed cornering. In modern vehicle styling, excessive camber, also known as demon camber, although can be aesthetically pleasing, can have an adverse effect on handling and be detrimental to tyre wear. Positive camber is rarely seen on road-going vehicles due to the reduced stability on cornering. However, it can be found on some off-road vehicles that have a greater suspension travel and whose load can vary. A positive camber can also go towards minimising steering effort. NASCAR and other cars that race on an oval circuit can have a very specific camber setup on the car to account for the banking and subsequent lateral forces and weight transfer applying in only one direction. This consists of a negative camber on the uphill side and a positive camber on the downhill side. Incorrect camber can visually display similar effects on tyre wear as incorrect wheel alignment, but without the feathering associated with the incorrect wheel alignment.